I will note, Madam Speaker, that the Virgo report had no mention of methamphetamines. It was the term that the government had not provided enough information to the author. But we need to be clear, meth is a different type of drug than opioids or alcohol. There is no such thing as a safe injection site for meth, and treatment and recovery are different too. When we talk about harm reduction with meth, we are talking about death reduction and disease reduction. It's said that we should love the sinner but hate the sin. This is also true of addiction, that we need to separate the human being from their addiction. Addicts should be treated in hospitals and clinics, not jails and remand. We know the need is increasing. We know the federal government is providing $400 million more over the next 10 years for mental health and home care. And we know that this government is going to have a new revenue stream from cannabis sales. A 9% markup on wholesale, a 6% fee on top of that, and on top of that, a federal excise tax from which the province will get 75% of the revenue. Will this government commit today to applying cannabis revenues to prevention and to creating new spaces for addictions treatment and recovery?
The Honourable First Minister.
Quick to spend, Madam Speaker, over there, and ready to throw money at a problem that we're not sure we have. The member has failed to reveal any analysis that he has done. We have certainly done a lot here to determine that we don't expect a net. There's a difference between gross revenue and net, and I'll get the member to look that up. The fact is that we aren't going to be expecting any major revenue flows to solve all the problems the member has begun to list and will, I'm sure, continue to list as the days go on. And so, Madam Speaker, the member has suggested that the NDP are wrong in their assertion about the injection sites. He might like to have that debate with them. I'd suggest he's wrong in asserting that we can spend money that we do not have. Mm-hmm.